Dear student, today I'm going to discuss another problem of Irodov electrostatics, that is 3.3 problem. Two small equally charged spheres let tied from the same point having silk thread of length L. The distance between the sphere is x, which is very greater than L. Now let's see, first you draw the diagram. Let this is the rigid support. From the same point, two let this is one sphere and this is another sphere like this. This angle is theta and this length is given L. Total length is given x, that's why after separation I will write x by 2, here also x by 2. This angle is also theta. Now if mass of the sphere is m, m is the mass of each sphere, let me balance the equation by applying the forces. At this particular position, let T is the tension in a string and mg is the weight, which is vertically downward. You need to find out the rate dq upon dt. For this we need to find out the charge in the function of time. Let's see, if this angle is theta, this will be corresponding angle theta, and this component I can write mg cos theta. Similarly, perpendicular component which is acting on this direction, that will be mg sin theta. And at this particular condition I can write as electric force between the sphere, I can write that will be mg sin theta at this valence condition. This will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. Charges of the sphere is same, that's why I can write let its charge is q. It becomes q square divided by separation between them is x, that's why it is x square, which is equal to mg sin theta. This will be the equation. Now I can calculate the sin theta over here. Sin theta from this equation, theta is what? Approximately sin theta is theta if angle if theta is small. Then I can write arc upon radius. Arc is x, x by 2 plus x by 2. And total radius is L, but it is twice, that's why it is called 2L, x by 2L. In one, you can calculate the angle theta, x upon 2L, because arc is x upon 2 and length is L, radius. Now, if you substitute in the previous equation, you will get 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q square divided by x square, which is equal to mg sin theta. I can write x upon 2L. Now you need to find out the value of charge, that will be when you cancel out 2 with 2 epsilon naught, can write in numerator 2 pi epsilon naught into mg divided by L. This will be value of, and left part is x, value of x become 3 by 2 because it become q, half is 2. Now, in order to find out the dq by dt, a rate of charge flow, that is dq by dt, I can write this whole is constant, that's why you can take it out, 2 pi epsilon naught mg whole divided by L raised to power 1 by 2. Now differentiate it, 3 by 2 will come out. And x raised to power 3 by 2 minus 1. That will be 1 by 2. And dx upon dt by differentiation. As we know, dx upon dt is what? That is velocity. And velocity is given in the question. That will be a upon root x. A is constant here, a upon root x. Let me put in the previous equation. I can write dq upon dt is equal to 2 pi epsilon naught mg upon L under root and 3 by 2 as it is. In place of dx by dt, I can write a upon root x. Root x will cancel out. And finally, value of dq by dt, I can write that will be 3a upon 2 into under root of 2 pi epsilon naught mg whole divided by L.